Hey everyone, welcome back to the Hair Loss Show. In today's episode, we're going to talk about finasteride as well, but not so much on the outcome of a treatment, but what its hormonal effect is. So stick around. Hey everyone, welcome back to the show. We've talked a lot about finasteride in the past. We know that finasteride is a medication that you can take to help treat androgenic alopecia or male pattern hair loss. And what finasteride actually does is it blocks the type 2 version of the 5-alpha reductase enzyme. So we know that testosterone gets converted into dihydrotestosterone, and dihydrotestosterone being, you know, one of the implicating factors that results in the hair follicle being miniaturized over a variety of different life cycles of that hair. And so what we're trying to do is lower the level of that DHT by blocking the enzyme that causes that conversion. And so really when we're looking at it, what we're doing is altering hormonal levels. And I wanted to address that because a lot of people do, when they hear that statement, are sort of taken aback a little bit, or certainly a bit reserved in terms of, you know, wanting to start therapy, especially with finasteride. And I understand the hesitation there, because a lot of people don't really want to play around with hormonal levels. And that's true. You don't want to, because all of these things have a knock-on effect. If you look at the biochemical pathway of how all these hormones are built or made in the body, it's a beautiful cascade of different chain and chemical reactions, one thing that leads on to the next. If you block one pathway, you open up another pathway. So everything has a trade-off. And so we want to understand that, look, if we are blocking the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone, then yes, it stands to reason that your testosterone levels are going to go up. And now for some people, that may seem like a real bonus, because testosterone is a great hormone for a lot of guys, right? We know that testosterone after the age of 35 in most men starts to decline. And testosterone is great, not just for, you know, muscle building and for libido, but is also good for the heart and is good for the brain as well. So testosterone has a lot of positives there. And so if we are able to increase the testosterone while saving our hair, it kind of seems like a win-win. And yes, that's true. But on one hand, probably the dose that we're using of finasteride is probably not going to result in a significant increase in testosterone. Looking at it the other way, if you wanted to increase your testosterone, we wouldn't be giving you finasteride in order to do that. You'd be looking at just giving someone testosterone directly. But and the reason we're doing that is because fundamentally it's not about bringing the DHT or the dihydrotestosterone levels down to zero. We just want to reduce it below a certain threshold, which for you, the threshold of what is causing you to lose your hair. And that's not an easy one to figure out, and it varies from person to person. But we want to sort of titrate, and that's where the concept of customized dosing comes from, where we're titrating the dose of finasteride so that it brings that DHT level up below a certain threshold for you. And yes, that may result in a slight increase in testosterone levels, which are a good thing. But like I said, everything has a give and take. And we know that there are a number of different pathways that testosterone, if the levels are high, can go down. Testosterone can be just metabolized, and that's great. It can be broken down into other things like estrogen. And that's not such a great thing in some guys, because high levels of estrogen can cause issues with your prostate as well. So all of these things, it's very important to take heed of that and make sure that we're not causing massive swings in hormonal levels. Again, giving the lowest dose that you can to achieve the maximum outcome is probably what we're aiming for when we're trying to customize the dose for you. So it is important to look at it from a holistic picture, look at the whole biochemistry, and that's why you need someone who's actually able to give you advice and be able to titrate that dose specifically for you. So I hope that gives you sort of some insight into how we look at hormonal levels, how we look at dosing of finasteride, and why we're thinking about things in that respect. I hope you found that interesting. Thanks again for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you on the next episode. Take care.